गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स. सो टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस चैप्टर नंबर 3, दैट इज केमिकल रिएक्शंस एंड इक्वेशंस. सो टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस ऑक्सीडेशन रिएक्शन, रिडक्शन रिएक्शन, ऑक्सीडेंट और ऑक्सीडाइजिंग एजेंट, रिडक्टेंट और रिड्यूसिंग एजेंट, रिडॉक्स रिएक्शन, ओके, एंड कोरोजन एंड रेंसिडिटी. सो योर फर्स्ट टॉपिक इज ऑक्सीडेशन रिएक्शन. सो हाउ यू विल डिफाइन ऑक्सीडेशन रिएक्शन? सो इफ यू वांट टू डिफाइन व्हाट इज ऑक्सीडेशन रिएक्शन, सो यू मे डिफाइन अ रिएक्शन इन विच reactant combines from oxygen to form product is known as oxidation reaction, or a chemical reaction in which reactant loses hydrogen to form product is known as oxidation reaction. So I will give you one example of oxidation reaction. ऑक्सीडेशन रिएक्शन. सी दिस इज मैग्नीशियम Mg प्लस O2. दीज टू आर रिएक्टेंट. There are two reactant. First one is magnesium and second one is oxygen. So in this reactant, if both the reactant reacts, it will form magnesium oxide, MgO. If you want to balance it, see, here is two oxygen, here is one oxygen, so multiply by two. Now magnesium is two, magnesium is one, so we will multiply here by 2. So you can see here, in the magnesium there is no oxygen, but when, and this is the reactant, and in case of in the product side, see, magnesium have oxygen. So a reaction in which reactant gain oxygen is known as oxidation reaction, or simply a chemical reaction in which reactant loses hydrogen is known as oxidation reaction. So one more example I will take. For example, MgH2. Here is only one reactant. If you will heat magnesium hydride, then it will convert into magnesium plus H2. So you can see here, in the reactant there is hydrogen atoms, but in the product there is no hydrogen atom with magnesium. So in this case, in this example, reactant is losing hydrogen, but in this case reactant is gaining oxygen. Understood? So I repeat, what is oxidation reaction? A chemical reaction in which reactant combines with oxygen is known as oxidation reaction, or a chemical reaction in which reactant loses hydrogen is known as oxidation reaction. And I have written, if positive charge on any atoms or any ions increases, then again that will come in the category of oxidation reaction. I mean to say, for example, if on any atom or any ions positive charge increase or negative charge decrease, then that is also called oxidation reaction. For example, suppose this is iron Fe2 plus. Now on iron atom there is positive charge. Now this is ion, or more precisely this is cations, because if there is any positive charge on any atom, that is called cations, and if on any atoms there is negative charge, then that is called anions. Okay, so if you withdraw one electrons from this iron atoms, then it will convert into Fe3 plus and one electrons will release. So you can see here on the this iron atoms positive, there was 2 unit positive charge, but here there is 3 unit positive charge. It means here oxidation is taking place, oxidation of Fe2 plus ions. And if you reverse it, like Fe3 plus, if you give one electron, to Fe3 plus, it will convert into Fe2 plus. Here positive charge on the iron atom is decreasing. Here is positive charge was plus 3 units and here plus 2 units. So this is the example of reduction reaction. But this is the example of oxidation reaction. Here oxidation of Fe2 plus is taking place, but here reduction of Fe3 plus is taking place. Understood? So that's why I have written here positive charge increases or negative charge decreases. And in case of reduction, positive charge decreases or negative charge increases. Okay? So now I will explain reduction reaction. So you have to learn the definition and at least one example of each reaction. I have told you in the previous lecture as well. I will take only one example of reduction reaction. So what is now reduction reaction? So a chemical reaction in which reactants gain hydrogen. In the case of oxidation reaction, reactant combines with oxygen or reactant loses hydrogen. But in the case of reduction reaction, a chemical reaction in which reactant combines with hydrogen and loses oxygen is known as reduction reaction. One example I will give you. Like H2 plus Cl2, it gives HCl. If you want to balance it, so you have to multiply by 2. And I have explained you in very detail how to balance a chemical equation. So you can see here, in chlorine, here there are two reactants. First one is hydrogen, second one is chlorine. So focus on this chlorine atoms. In this chlorine atoms or in the reactant side, there is no hydrogen is separate. But this chlorine is combining with hydrogen and forming the product. So see, in the chlorine there is hydrogen atoms are there. It means reactant gains or reactant combines hydrogen to form product. This is the product, this is the reactant. So this is called reduction reaction, a chemical reaction in which reactant combines with hydrogen or loses oxygen is known as reduction reaction. So this one I have explained you, this one also I have explained you. Now first of all I will explain oxidation redox reaction, then oxidant and oxidizing agent. and reductant or reducing agent. So next topic is redox reaction. Redox reaction, this is oxidation plus reduction. So a chemical reaction in which oxidation and reduction take place simultaneously is known as redox reaction. One example I will give you. Say this is copper oxide CuO plus H2. If copper oxide combines with hydrogen, it forms copper plus water H2O. So you can see here, see, in the this is copper oxide. So consider this copper oxide. So in the copper oxide, if you see in the product side, this copper have no oxygen. Here is oxygen with copper, but here is single oxygen. It means reactant is losing oxygen from the reactant. Here reactant, that is copper oxide is losing oxygen. So here oxidation of copper oxide is taking place. Here oxidation of copper oxide is taking place. So here oxidation of which reactant? Oxidation of, we can say in this reaction, oxidation of copper oxide is taking place. But if you consider this one hydrogen, that is H2. So here is in this reactant, in the reactant hydrogen, if you consider on hydrogen atoms, you can see from hydrogen there is oxygen is combined. It means this reactant hydrogen is combining with oxygen. Hydrogen is combining with oxygen. So here oxidation of H2 is taking place. Here oxidation of which reactant? Oxidation of H2. Understood? So this is the example of redox reaction. This is the example of redox reaction. The reason oxidation and reduction, sorry, this is reduction, because reactant is losing hydrogen. So this is the reduction. So oxidation and reduction taking place simultaneously. So that is called redox reaction. Okay, now what is oxidant and or oxidizing agent? See, oxidation of H2 is taking place, but this oxygen is why hydrogen is here, oxidation of H2 is taking place due to this copper oxide. So this will be the oxidizing agent. Due to copper oxide, oxidation of hydrogen is taking place. So this will be the oxidizing agent. Okay. So what is oxidizing agent or oxidant? So I will give you the definition. Such chemical substances which brings about an oxidation reaction by making oxygen available are called oxidant or oxidizing agent. Oxidant or oxidizing agent, this provides oxygen to the other atoms, to the other reactant. So this is called, in this example, this copper oxide is called oxidant or oxidizing agent. Understood? And if you consider this one, here reduction is taking place, reduction of copper oxide is taking place, but this reduction is due to hydrogen. This reduction is taking place, why reduction is taking place here? Due to this hydrogen. So this will be the reducing agent. This will be, because see, always remember, here reduction is taking place, reduction of copper oxide. So this reduction is taking place due to this hydrogen. So this hydrogen will be called reducing agent in this reaction. Understood? So remember, just opposite, copper oxide reduction is taking place. So reduction is taking place. So this will be the oxidizing agent. See, here oxidation is taking place. So this will be the reducing agent. Okay? Now next topic is corrosion. So what is corrosion? So corrosion can be defined as the process through which refined metals are converted into more stable compound such as metal oxides, metal sulfides or metal hydroxide. But in this chapter, we will study corrosion of iron articles. Simply, when iron articles, when iron react with oxygen plus moisture, it forms iron oxide Fe2O3 and XH2O. Simply, this is rust. Simply, this is called. It means for the corrosion of metals, oxygen is necessary, as well as with oxygen, there must be moisture should be present in the air. Without moisture and oxygen, corrosion of iron articles cannot be take place. So here we have to study corrosion of iron articles only. Okay, so this is called rust. Sometimes in your question paper, in MCQ, what is the chemical formula of rust? Then you have to say Fe2O3.XH2O. What is X? X is a variable number. If more moistures are there in the place of X, maybe it may be, this is a variable. So maybe 10H2O. If less moisture are there, so it may be in the place of 5H2O. If no moisture are there, so simply that will be Fe2O3 only. Okay, so this is the rust. You have to write XH2O. X is the variable. Understood? So what is rust? The rust on iron does not form by a simple chemical reaction with oxygen with iron surface. I repeat, the rust on iron does not form by a simple reaction of oxygen with iron. The rust is formed by an electrochemical reaction. Rust is not formed by simple a chemical reaction. Rust is formed on the basis of electrochemical reaction. Okay? Different region on the same surface on iron becomes anode and cathode. The rust on the iron does not form by a simple reaction of oxygen with iron surface. The rust is formed by an electrochemical reaction. Rust is not formed by simple reaction. Rust is formed on the basis of electrochemical reaction. What is electrochemical reaction? So in a electrochemical reaction, iron surface on iron surface one some side will become anode, one some side will be acts like anode, and another side will behave like cathode. Say this is anode region, anode, and this became cathode. Okay, so in anode region what happened? So this is iron articles. On this iron articles, one area became anode and another area acts like a cathode. So in anode region, what happened? Iron is oxidized to form Fe2+ in the anode region. So in the anode region, what happened? Iron Fe solid, it oxidizes to Fe2+ aqueous means presence of water, plus 2e, two electrons released from this iron. So I have written here, this is the reaction in the anode region. And what exactly happened in cathode region? In cathode region, O2, oxygen gas present in the atmosphere, react with 4H+ aqueous 4E- to form. You have to remember this reaction. Cathode region, Fe, iron oxidized, Fe2+ two electrons released from this iron. And in this cathode region, oxygen react with 4H+ aqueous plus 4E, it converted into 2H2O liquid, alpha liquid. And this Fe2+ migrate from anode region to another region. This Fe2+ migrated from this anode region to other region on the same surface of iron articles and oxidized to Fe3+, and this became in this region. Initially Fe2+ is here, but this Fe2+ will migrate from this areas, this region, from anode region, and this will come into another region on the same surface of the iron articles. And this Fe oxidized to Fe3+ in the presence of water. And this further Fe, this suppose in this area, this Fe2+ became Fe3+. And this Fe3+ further react Fe3+, this react aqueous plus water molecules 4H2O liquid gives Fe2O3, that is iron oxide, which was written here. Simply I have written like this. But these all are the entire process to form rust. These all are the internal process, we can say. Simply we write Fe react with oxygen in moisture, it forms rust. But exact, this is the main process, electrochemical. These all are the, I am explaining electrochemical reaction, how rust is formed during chemical reaction. So this forms Fe2+ and H2O solid plus 6H+ aqueous. Okay, this is the color of rust, is reddish color. Okay, so these all were the this was the electrochemical reaction inside the iron article, okay, or on the surface of iron article. This is the formula of rust. Formula of rust is Fe2O3H2O, or we can write simply for in general term XH2O. If water will be more number of H2O will be present here. If less water molecules is there, then less water molecules will be present in this in the rust. Okay. So last topic is that is rancidity. This is theoretical topic. So what is rancidity? Rancidity. Rancidity. So when we used old leftover cooking oil for making food stuff, it is found to have fall order called rancidity. If it is cooked in such oil, its taste also changes. When oil or ghee is left aside for a long time, or fried food is left aside for a long time, it undergoes air oxidation and becomes rancid. Rancidity is in the food stuff cooked in oil or ghee is prevented by using antioxidant. If you want to prevent oxidation, you have to use antioxidant. Okay, the process of oxidation reaction of food stuff can also be shown during the storing in airtight container. So if you want to prevent oxidation in a container, then you have to use airtight container so that oxidation can be prevented. So you may have seen in the chips there is nitrogen gas is filled inside the chips of the packet of the chips. Why nitrogen gas is inside the chips packet? The reason is due to the nitrogen gas, they prevent oxidation of the food. So this all was the chemical reaction and equation. I hope you have understood. For exercise, many questions are given. So I will share you a link in the WhatsApp group, and from there you can write all the answer of the exercise. Okay, so thank you so much. Take care.